practice picking up Apple frameworks. And I say this for two reasons. One, a huge part of being an iOS dev is working with these frameworks, and Apple's constantly releasing new ones. So being able to pick them up quickly is huge. And two, when you work with a brand new one, like Tipkit in iOS 17, you know, there's not a ton of tutorials, there's not a bunch of Stack Overflow articles. So you are forced to dive into the documentation and learn it on your own, which is another must-have skill. So work on building tiny, single-feature projects using things like MapKit, ARKit, WidgetKit, etc. The ability to quickly pick up a new framework is vital, and you'll be much better for it.
Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace.
Number two, spend a chapter of your career as a contractor slash freelancer. Now, to be clear, I'm not talking about, you know, a long-term contract with one company, because at that point, you might as well just be a full-time employee. I'm talking about, you know, a couple months here, a couple months there, maybe working on multiple projects at the same time. And again, I have two reasons for this. The first one is exposure. If you do this for a couple years, right, a couple months here, a couple months there, multiple projects, you're going to get exposed to a ton of code bases and a wide variety of, you know, coding styles, architectures, pull request processes, tooling, not to mention all the various types of apps you're gonna work on. So that exposure will make you a way better iOS developer, because you'll see some things you like, you'll see some things you hate, but being exposed to all that is going to help shape your own coding style, your own coding philosophy, and the best philosophies come from experiencing a wide variety of things. Now, my second reason for spending a chapter of your career as a contractor slash freelancer is after you've proven to yourself that you can get contracts, you know how to live this lifestyle, you have this as an option. And that's the beauty of being a software developer. Just the optionality in this career is crazy, right? Want to work at a big company? Cool. Small startup. You want to do the contracting slash freelancing. Maybe you want to build your own app, or maybe there's a combination, right? Maybe you work full time, do freelancing on the side. Again, the optionality is insane. And once you know how to do contracting, right, you've proven to yourself that you can do it. Well, now you have this option in your toolbox whenever you need it. So like I said, you get exposure to a ton of code bases, a wide variety of coding styles. You can build your own philosophy. You have it as an option whenever you need it in your career. And it can be quite lucrative. So just wins all around. Number three is a quick one. Read Apple's human interface guidelines once a year, probably right after WWDC, because that's when a lot of the major changes happen. But if you're not familiar with what Apple's human interface guidelines are, or the HIG for short, it's basically Apple's design best practices for all their platforms, right? Straight from Apple itself. For example, the design philosophy for a Mac app, where you have a mouse pointer, things are small, you can be more precise, are very different than the design philosophy for an iOS app, where you got big fat fingers trying to hit big fat buttons, right? Completely different worlds. And the HIG now has a section for VisionOS. You know, as we embark into this new spatial computing paradigm, Apple's got you covered on how to build a properly designed app for the Vision Pro. So take some time after WW each year to review the HIG, so Apple's design best practices are just second nature to you. Number four, when it comes to accepting a job, if you're fortunate enough to get multiple job offers, prioritize the better team over more money, especially earlier in your career, because the effects of this compound over time. Here's an extreme example. Let's say you can go to a team of just awesome people, world-class developers, just highly skilled, they're well-connected in the developer world. Well, I think it's obvious that you're gonna learn a ton, your skills are gonna skyrocket. I think that's the obvious thing. The maybe not so obvious thing is how this team can help you over the long run of your career. Because again, these are world-class developers, well-connected in the developer world. So naturally, you know, they're gonna go on to other companies, or maybe they'll start their own startup and wanna bring you along. Or maybe they can recommend you to your next job. You can see how a job on a good team has way more benefits than just the salary alone. So in my opinion, even if you have to take 10, 20, 30% less money right now, the benefits of the growth in your skills, the growth in your network, just knowing all these high-class developers, right? Having a network is great. Having a high-quality network is even better. So yeah, in the short run, you're gonna take less money, but over the long run of your career, the growth in your skills, the network you've gained, that is going to dwarf your career trajectory if you took the more money now, but on a much worse team. Number five, follow indie developers that are building in public on X, or formerly Twitter. Now, even if you have no interest in building your own app, you don't care about indie dev, like, I get it. The reason I'm recommending this is because those that are out there building in public, they're sharing every little detail of them building their apps. And the reality is that these indie developers, they get to like play, explore, and experiment like on the frontier, right? That you may not be able to do at a large company. And they're sharing everything, like from cool animations they're building, maybe a cool new widget design, or implementing the new stuff in iOS 17. They're just sharing all the cool stuff they're building across a wide variety of apps. You just can't help but get so many ideas and get inspired. Like, I just can't help but believe that will make you better, whether you want to build your own indie app or not. Like, being exposed to all that, you will become a better developer. Number six, and this one's not for everyone, but create content. Whether it's a blog, YouTube channel, podcast, newsletter, building in public on X, whatever. The idea here is that when you have to teach something or show someone how to do something, your understanding has to be a lot deeper than just building it yourself. So by creating content around what you're learning, let's say, for example, you learned how to create a calendar widget in SwiftUI. Great, write a blog post about that, create a video about that, because again, that will reinforce your learning on just that topic, sure, but if you play this out to where you've done this for a year or two, you've created content around multiple topics. Well, all that learning is going to be so reinforced for yourself, but a little side benefit of this, if you do it enough over a long period of time, you're going to start to build a name for yourself in the community. You're going to have a nice little brand. Maybe you can make a little extra side income from it. Hell, who knows? Maybe it grows so much that it overtakes your developer salary and that's what you do full time. I don't know. It can happen. But at the very least, you will build a little bit of a name for yourself in the community, build a little bit of a brand, and you will get opportunities from that that you would not have gotten otherwise. Because when you put your work out there, people know who you are. They know what you can do. And you'd be surprised who reaches out to you. So at a minimum, creating content will reinforce your learning, making you a better developer, and who knows where that brand can grow to over time and what opportunities may come from that. So now that you've built a few small projects, picking up new frameworks, you got a lot of projects from your contracting, maybe you built your own app, you're gonna need a place to showcase all your work. And that brings me to today's sponsor, Squarespace. Squarespace is an all-in-one platform to help you get that iOS developer portfolio, blog, or personal website up and running very quickly. Now I know, we're all developers with the skills and the desire to build the web page ourselves, but I would argue there's an opportunity cost to your time. If you're an iOS developer trying to build a great product, a great app, maybe spending a lot of time learning the ins and outs of web development, responsive design, isn't the best way to spend your time. That's why I recommend Squarespace to build that personal website, the blog, your portfolio, or maybe a landing page for your app. They have all kinds of beautiful themes and templates to get you started. They handle all the analytics and the SEO for you. Again, it just saves you so much time so you can get back to doing what you want to do, and that is building iOS apps. So when you're ready to get started, go to squarespace.com to start your free trial. And when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/SeanAllen to get 10% off your first purchase of a website or domain.